try to figure out what is the optimal alignment. How can we decide how to find an optimal alignment? So we go back to the same example. This is a sequence, and that sequence, etc. And as I said, we thought that this 10 out of 12 is optimal alignment. But can we prove it? Do we know that it is really optimal alignment? And actually, what do we mean with optimal alignment? We said the same thing, that the second alignment was not very good. It only contains 4 out of 12 identical residues. And we would assume that if we do the third alignment, the same sequence as the second case, that is a bad alignment, because it has 11 out of 12 identical sequences. But on the other hand, we also have 5 gaps. 4 in one sequence and 1 in another sequence. So all these differences are marked in red. So is it the ultimate goal just to optimize the number of identical positions, or is it something else we want to do? So well, actually, if you use a scoring matrix, that is means that we get a certain point, certain score, when we align a certain amino acid, certain residue, certain new letter to another letter. So in this case, if we use a score matrix, that gives you, if two T's are aligned, it gives you a 5. If two H's is aligned, it gives you an 8. If an I is aligned to a minus, to an A, it gives minus 1, etc. So you see here what the scores are. How these are obtained and why we have these scores is something called, we calculate the scores called log odds ratio. So basically the log of the probability that these two residues are aligned to each other. We will come back to that later. At the moment, we are thinking that these are scores. If you take that, you have a score of 52 in the first case, and you have a score of 18 in the third case, and a score of 56 in the last case. So that means that 56 is higher than 18, so that is the better alignment. And you see, in this case, we score only 0 for gap penalties, for gaps, yes. It doesn't cost anything for the gap, which might not be completely realistic, but that is really the case here. And so then, if we put out these rules, we could have as a goal to obtain the alignment that gives the highest score. And this is what we mean with an optimal alignment. And actually, often what we do is that the cost has to introduce gaps, we put in minus 1 on each gaps, still the third alignment is much better than the second alignment. 51 instead of 18.